Oh, you were dressed for the show.
All right. I had to put my uniform on.
But, you know, he signed Janet Jackson.
You used to play his stuff from that album. What was your band called again?
Junior Brass.
Junior Brass.
That's right.
And the logo was, listen to Junior Brass or we'll kick your ass. Getting ready for the show. House is lining up. And we're sitting next to this fine young gentleman wearing the A&M Records logo.
Albert and Moss.
Yes, awesome.
And they signed the Carpenters. And
I'm Ange, nice to meet you.
Dave.
Dave, and, awesome.
And
he this signed is Art.
Art, okay, they signed the Carpenters, the Police. Now I'm going blank.
No, that's okay.
I think I remember a Captain and Tennille record being
Captain,
A&M
Bobby
Records.
Captain, yeah. Bobby Captain and Tennille, yeah.
Yeah.
I'm just going blank, but you gave chances to people.
Hello! We sat down in our nice seats, met some great people. Saw talking in the A&M record shirt, but the Jolly Green Giant just happened to sit down right in front of me. I'm sure he's a very nice man. He is just a lot taller. So we're recording from way up here. Kudos to the sound control people.
In the words of the great Louis Armstrong, in answer to young people saying, what do you mean it's a wonderful world? Well, how about all those wars all over the place? You call that wonderful? And how about hunger and pollution? That ain't so wonderful either. It ain't the world that's so bad. It's what we're doing to it. What a wonderful world it would be if only we would give it a chance.
Love, baby, love. That's the secret.
Questions, any ideas? I didn't say you could shout. No, that's okay. Where you going? Oh, yeah, look at it. Hey, we're going to hang on. I don't want to lose control so soon.
Spanish play.
You want to hear the TJB medley?
Okay,
check. Wherever we go, there's somebody who says, you know that Whipped Cream and Under the Lights album you did? Yeah. I tell you. Hang on one second. This guy comes up to me. This is serious. This happened. A month after that Whipped Cream and Under the Lights album was released. And says, you know, Mr. Albert, I think you should win an award for that cover. I love it. I love the girl. I love the whipped cream. I didn't have the heart to tell him it was shaving cream, but he says, I love the type. I love the whole thing, man. God bless you. Thank you. I said, well, what about the music? He said, well, I haven't had a chance to listen to that. Yeah, I'm telling you, the moment it was released. That happened. Sounds like a funny story to tell, but that happened to me. A lot of strange things have happened through the years. I'll tell you about some of them as we go. But I'm going to play a little medley that you might all enjoy. I mean, deja vu for days, because even as I play this medley, I think about the things and how the titles came about, etc. So I hope you enjoy this. This is it's going to start out with the request in the front row said Rise. It's going to start out with Rise.
Thank you.
Like you have to help me with this a song I did in 1968. We were doing a television show, and the director, Jack Haley Jr., said, he said, why don't you try singing a song, man? I'm tired of photographing you and putting the trumpet in your mouth. So I thought, if I could find the right song, I don't think of myself as a singer, but you know, if you have the right song and the right arrangement behind you, nice start. So I called a friend of mine. His name is Bert Bacharach. You know Bert? Yeah. So it's a question I always ask the great songwriters, and Bert is certainly one of the greatest. I said, man, is there a, you know, I told him what was happening. We're doing this television show, and the director wanted me to sing, and if I could find a song that I could handle, I'd like to give it a go. You sing out, even if you can't, you don't think you can sing. Here it comes. You see this sky, can't hear you. This sky's in love with you. Yes, I'm in love. Who looks at you the way I do? When you smile, I can't tell. We know we just. How can I show you? I'm glad. Don't give up. I got to know you, 'cause I need your love, and I want your love. Say you're in love, in love with this guy. Very, very, very good. Wow. That felt good. It surprised me. It really did. You guys blend nicely. Very nice sound together. What are you doing tomorrow night? Honey, thank you. You know, I'm just doing what I love to do. I honestly am just, you know, in the moment of my life when I'm playing, it's fabulous therapy, I guess. I don't know what you call it. Anyways, let me tell you about, you know, these mysterious titles that guys give for songs and girls. You know, you think that the title really reflects what they were feeling in a deep vein.
Just like a star across the sky, like an angel off the page, you appear. Just like oil on my hands, I'm honored to love you. I don't wonder anymore. Thank you.
I see it now. Lemmy Hall featuring Herb the Lonely Bull in Alberta. Oh, baby. That was stunning. Absolutely. Breathtaking. Beautiful. You're welcome. Wow. I can't believe it. Are any of you on TikTok, do you know? What? You remember the song? I'll play a little bit so this refresh your memory. Thank you. Siempre a domingo, no? Sí, thank you very
Woo,
much.
Raul!
Okay, so I did this show, and the, I don't know if it was the producer or
what,
the people that were affiliated with the show, they picked me up at the airport, took me to my hotel, they ran a suite for me at the Casa Isabella. He opens the door, and there's a mariachi band playing. Good morning, Mr. Sunshine. Musicians.
Really?
Right. whenever I play. Check this out. I was playing at a resort when I was 18 years old in Ontario, California, and they had a Stump the Band contest. And I can play, if I hear the song, I can play it. So George Harrison had a record label called Dark Horse.
Oh, yeah.
And it was distributed by A&M. I love George, and he was a good guy. He spent a lot of time on our A&M lot. So much time, he married one of our secretaries, Olivia. But this was a good guy. He gave back. You know, he raised a lot of money for some really good causes, and I liked him a lot. We were not buddy-buddy, but there's something about him that said, yeah, I like this guy. And I think he wrote one of the most beautiful Beatles songs called Something. I'm going to play that for you. You guys are going to sing the middle part, you know, oh. At the Copacabana, okay? With the same gusto you had for this guy's mind. But check this out. Yeah, the words will be up on the screen. So,
karaoke hour.
Here's the beauty part of this idea. Hussein's going to sing the first verse in English. And Lonnie, unbeknownst to her, she's going to sing the second verse in Portuguese. This is a trick. You can't believe her, how she can translate English into Portuguese. I've heard you do that with Mandarin. You can do it, Lonnie. I know you can do it. Okay, so this is... I'm telling you, I know you can do it, baby. Just trust me on this. Yeah. So, okay, this is our version of the Copacabana. You're going to see on the screen. I'm going to get on your way. And thank you so much for being here. This was fun for me.
She was a showgirl with yellow bows and her hair. Have you got some?